Alright, hello and good evening, guys. Welcome, welcome. Hello there, Avocado. Hi, how are you doing? I'm doing great as always. And hello and a pleasant good morning or good afternoon or good evening, wherever you may be in the world. I didn't know you had an Instagram. I will follow. Yeah, sure, go ahead and do that. And yes, I actually do. So go ahead and follow, and I will be approving your request once I get the excuse me. Once I get the follow request. But anyway, welcome, and tonight, well, some of you may have seen, I was streaming yesterday evening, but my stream got cut a bit short. It wasn't as long as my usual streams that lasts for about 3 hours, because I had a bit of a stomachache yesterday, and my stomach wasn't really cooperating with me, so I had to cut it short. I wanted to go back live again when I went to BRB, but sadly I wasn't able to do so. But here I am, I'm back, and I'm feeling better. And tonight, what was supposed to be finished by yesterday evening during my stream is, tonight we will be continuing and finally finishing the airport terminal build that I have started the other day. Also, I will be building a hangar bar, if I'm pronouncing it right. So yeah, I will be building that beside the terminal building that we have in Newcrest. So without further ado, thank you, Avocado. Well, I am feeling better now though, so don't worry about that. I'm all good. That's what I wouldn't be streaming if I wasn't feeling better anyway. So anyway, all right, so let's go ahead and get into the game, shall we? Here, all right. Okay, where is the terminal that we were building? So yeah, well, this time around I didn't do anything off stream. Actually, I just kept it as is because I was trying to have a hold of myself, see how am I doing and so, but I wasn't able to continue to do anything off stream for this terminal build. But so but I will be finishing this tonight, as well as I will be building a hangar, something that will look like a hangar over here. Beside it, we'll have another runway, and I will have like two hangars over here that will actually be a bar, replacing this one, I guess, or a nightclub rather. I could do both actually, but well. Anyway, so yeah, that is our goals for tonight's stream. So yeah, let's go ahead and finish the... let's go ahead and finish this airport terminal. So first of all, okay, let's just have it load for it a bit. Ooh, okay. Anyway, before I go ahead and build and continue finishing this terminal, I would like to rename this lot from Lama Municipal Airport to the terminal, because since this will be like a restaurant, an airport that became a restaurant, that would be a more appropriate name, I guess. Well, it may be generic, but I sort of have some references for it. Like, If you might recall, there is a movie titled The Terminal, starring Tom Hanks and Catherine Zeta-Jones. So that's basically where I got the reference. And since this building won't really function as an airport and it will function as a restaurant instead, so I sort of thought it would be more appropriate to name it as The Terminal rather than having its original name like Dalama International Airport. Or I was thinking earlier like Dalama Terminal, but I'm like, not really. But anyway, so yeah, this is what I have done with the build so far. I have partially furnished the check-in area, the security area, the boarding gates, the immigration area for the arrivals, and the baggage claim area. So yeah, I just sort of improvised actually for the furniture that I have placed in all the areas. So for something, for all this, for this to look like a baggage carousel slash conveyor, I sort of used these coffee tables instead, so it will look like a conveyor. Or I did the same here on the check-in area where I had these same tables as conveyors, so that it'll look like that's where you will place the baggage and it will go ahead to where the baggage will go to the trains and all that. Ooh, okay, now that I used this idea, I'd use this mirrors over here, I might as well do that over here so that it'll look like there is a hole going here so that it'll look like the conveyor belt is continuous and all that. So okay, let me go ahead and do the same thing over here. Oh, avocado, thank you by the way for yesterday, because I remember. Who was that again? Let me just go ahead and check. I remember yesterday that Crazy Crow stopped by in my stream and even hosted me yesterday's, and he told me actually that you sent him. So thank you for that, actually. I really appreciate it that you've done that, so thank you. Thank you. Anyway, well, now that we're here and all that, let's go ahead and I want to place some rugs over here, like a carpet, a queue carpet. I want it to be red. Is there a red queue carpet here of some sort? Alright, that'll work. There you go. So that'll look like a carpet for the queue for the check-in area. There we go. I mean, that's starting to look good. And then I think we not necessarily don't need to add any more stuff in here over here at the baggage claim area, since that's already good enough. It's just a matter of us needing to place some more wallpapers in all the areas. I think I could also do the same and add some rugs over here at the security area. Just for more. There we go. And then we'll have some chairs over here. So for those people who will be wearing their stuff again after security check and all that, and we'll also place a table, I guess, over here. I need a long table. I wonder which table I should go for. Oh, I guess this one would do perfectly. There we go. That looks okay. Then let's go ahead and place a painting above that, since it would look better if we did add some decor over there. Okay, which painting should I go for? I wonder. I think I'm gonna go ahead and settle with this painting. Then I'm gonna go for classic lighting fixtures rather. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and choose this lighting fixture. There we go. I mean, that's already looking good. And we'll also have one right about here. Then we can have a fancy little plant over here, I guess, on this corner. I wonder which one I should choose. I mean, this looks too classic. Let's see. Bob tree. I could definitely do that, but it's going to cut through that wall. Oh, perhaps this one. The vase. The vase. There we go. I mean, that looks good. And then, what we could do is we will also have this lighting fixtures over here. We'll also have it over here. There we go. Wait a sec. Can we change to. Oh, we can't. Okay, let's keep it to that. How about let's change it to that shade of white, so that it will blend better with the windows and the doors that we have. Right, that's a better choice. There we go. So that will do it for the security area, I guess. I think we can have a hanging plant over here at this wall, since it looks a bit bare. I'm gonna go ahead and place one of these. There we go. Then I'll do the same on the other side. There! That looks way better. Also, I could have this same plant on this corner as well. Then what I could do is also duplicate these lighting fixtures, and I will place them right about here. Here, here. Nope, that's a bit low. I will adjust that later. No, not right now. Do that right now. Okay, so there, there. On the opposite sides. And then I might as well do one over here. Then what I can do is rather than to have a long. I might as well have this table as well, actually. Like for people to fill up their forms with. They can use that table, and then I could also have chairs for those waiting in the queue. Alright. Then I could also go for the same paintings or painting rather. I could go for the same painting, and then we'll also have the same lighting fixture there and there. Awesome. That's looking better. Alright. Then, as for this long stretch of wall over here, this is going to be quite a challenge. For this long, wait, I think I sort of planned on having several television monitors over here. Or should I go for that? Well, let's see. Let's go ahead and put some lighting fixtures first. So what we will do is we'll go ahead and place these. I mean, does that look good? I mean, I want to have something more because this is too huge. See? I wanted to have that, but it was too huge. Ooh, this one though looks perfect. So let's go ahead and place these lighting fixtures instead. Since it does give me that classic airport vibe. There you go. It looks so fancy. It looks so fancy. It does look like more of a lobby of a hotel, but that's what. Hi there, Mimo. Hello. How are you doing today? There we go. I mean, classic airports. I mean, airports back in the day look very fancy, and they also happen to look like. Hotel lobbies and all that, since basically, like what I said from my previous stream, flying back in the day was more of a luxury than a necessity before. So yeah, welcome to the Nixters, Weevil. Thank you very much for that follow. I appreciate it a lot. Thank you for that. Anyway, so let's go ahead and. I am doing good. Thank you very much for asking. That's great to hear. Alright. From Scotland. Wow, okay. I think it's a good thing that I finally managed to have someone from viewing from the UK. I mean, I think it's the first time, I guess. So, yeah. Anyway, I want to use the same lighting fixtures. Let's go ahead and use that on these two sides over here. On the entryway and the exitway. Because technically, how we'll go about with this is whenever someone arrives from the plane, they will go through this boarding gate and then they will be exiting over here, going through immigration. And then once they're through immigration and some sort, they will go ahead and go out in the baggage claim area. So, and then this will be the exit. Then the entrance would have to be over here. This is the check-in counters. Then once they're done checking in, they'll go through the security check. And then they'll go through the boarding gates over here. So yeah. At first I was really wondering, before I came up with this layout of the airport, I was wondering how to go about the flow of people, even though it won't function as an airport technically. But I wanted to have it look like, I wanted this build to, rather than just to build a random airport, I wanted it to be, I wanted it to look like more functional actually, like it's an actual functioning airport. So, even though it wouldn't be. So, yeah. Anyway. What was I supposed to do next? Oh, yes. Let's see if I could go ahead. Let's see how it will go once we go ahead and place TV monitors over here. I mean, it would make sense to place TV monitors since, it would make sense to place TV monitors since it's not re this airport wasn't re isn't really going to be more of a, how to say, at least I could think, or one could think, that these monitors would serve as those information monitors for as to when the flight will depart or when the flight will arrive and all that. So yeah, placing tele TV telebi. I almost said TV in the Japanese way, because in Japanese they call TVs here as terebi. So yeah, anyway, so as I was saying, it would make sense to have TV monitors over here. Then I guess I could go for the occasional painting over at the intervals on the over at these empty spaces over here. So let me go ahead and do that. There we go. That should take care of our information monitor needs. And then over here we will have random artwork, I guess. Or is there something in over at the decors that I could place that could serve? Oh, wait a minute, I have an idea. Now, where is that? Where is that latticed wall? In wall sculptures? Yes, I think it is. This one. I will have the brown one placed over here. So it will definitely look like wall art. There we go. And then, let's see, what else can we place in there? Oh, we can actually have like CCTV cameras over here on the security area. I mean, that would make sense. So we'll have security areas over here. There, above the lamps, and then we could also have over here and here on this edge. There we go. I mean, the security areas and the immigration areas have security security cameras after all, so it would make sense to have them there. So let's go ahead and place some more over here and over here. There we go. What else can we have there? Let me scale this up. There we go. Oh, that looks awesome. All right, I'm gonna go with that. That looks gorgeous. Okay, definitely gonna go. I'm gonna go all out with this. Ah, oh, well, look at that. Even though it still doesn't have any wallpaper, I'm already loving how it turns out. How it is turning out. Nice. Okay. What else? I mean, I think I would keep it as. Like so that it wouldn't look so cluttered. But what I will do is, I wonder. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Most definitely. I think I can have these butterflies over here. Maybe not. Maybe not. Wait, can we have fancy curtains over here at the windows? I mean, curtains that wouldn't really block the window and all that. Let's see. Okay, I wouldn't even bother. Okay. Since I hardly see any curtains in an airport anyway. But what I will do is I will have paintings over here, I guess. Which painting though? I think I'm gonna settle with that. Yes, most definitely. And then you could actually have a fireplace over there. Yeah, you most definitely can. There we go. I mean, that looks like a fancy boarding gate. Let's go ahead and do the same over here, on the other end. And then, I want to duplicate the same painting for symmetry. There we go. And then what we could do... what could we do over here? We could actually have these. There we go, and then we can also have this one, cool serenade, using this frame, like so. There we go. Now that's looking very fancy. And then, as for wallpaper, okay, let me just check something real quick. There we go. Awesome. As for wallpaper, is there something good with those with paneling? I mean, no. Let's see. Not really that. I could go for this one. Okay, let's find other alternatives, shall we? Just this one will look so... okay. I'm not really liking that. Wallpaper. No, this is too yellow. Over here, maybe. This one. Okay. Something cream-ish. I mean, this is the closest thing that I can find that will go, that that goes along with the color that I would love to have on this room, but hopefully there are other alternatives. We go ahead and find, look for some. This is good. And then, as for the flooring, we'll go with these fancy carpets. Something dark, maybe. Like, perhaps this. Oh, yes, this brown would do good. Here we go. Just the way I imagined it. Awesome. Alright, and then what we can do is we will have some. I'll go ahead and place some rugs over here. Let's see. Which rug to go for? I mean, that looks good. Alright, now that's looking good. There we go. I am loving how it looks like here on the inside. Like, seriously. Now let's go ahead and I think I'm gonna go for the same. Should I go for the same wallpaper? I mean, for consistency's sake, I think I can and I will do so. But I'm not exactly sure whether that will be a good idea. Since I think it will be a bit. It will be. Or it will look like it's a bit lazy if I do go for the same wallpapers for all the areas. In here, though, I think I want to go for something darker. I mean, the same wallpaper, but darker. Like perhaps this one. Or I could have something that has the white trim to go with the windows. There we go. I mean, that looks good. And then as for the flooring, should I go for this? I mean, this will be too dark, I guess. But it does work though. Oh wait. That works a bit better. I mean, just for change and for variation. That does look airporty after all. There we go. I think I'll go with that. I'll settle with that. I suppose I'll go ahead and do the same for the baggage claim area. I think I could go for something tiled, maybe. I'll go for this tile. Lighter. There we go. And then, as for wallpaper, Yeah, I do have a different shade. Is this one, if I believe, is... Yeah. This one's the same with the... Yeah, I guess we'll go with this one. Just for the sake of it, we have different wallpapers. I mean, I love... As much as I love symmetry and proportionality, I sort of want to make things a little bit different at times as well. Just for the sake that I wouldn't be called lazy. Anyway, yeah, I mean, that's looking good. There. As for the security areas. Ooh, okay, now I get it. For variation, we'll have that. Then we'll have the tiled area over here. We'll have the same tiles, like so. And then what we could do is, for the immigration area, we will have these. And then we'll have the same carpeting over here. There we go. Now that makes a lot of sense. Well, at least for me, that is. Anyway, there we go. Let's go ahead and have that wallpaper like so. And then as for this area over here, there we go. That looks good. It's pretty decent. I wonder how that looks like at night, though. Let's see. Oh, okay. Now that is a very well lit. Not really very well lit. I think I will do. But I do love how this toilet boarding gates area look, though. It looks so gorgeous. It's so gorgeous. Okay, what I think we could do is, we can have these lamps. We can have these hanging chandeliers over at this area right there. And then we can also have that on the very same place, right about here, like so. So that we'll have bright rooms. Also, I mean, I would love to have some signs over here behind the check-in counters showing which airlines are using these check-in counters and all that. Oh, wait a second, I think I can do something with that. Since we have these monitors right here, what we can do okay, I think that's a bit too high. Yep, that is a bit too high. Let's lower it a tad bit, like so. And then let's go ahead and duplicate it and do the same right in here, like so. That's looking good. It looks proportional. This lot is starting to cost a lot because of the television monitors. There we go. That looks good. Awesome. And then I think we could have a seating area over here. wonder about that seating area over there. I think I can do something else with that, with this area over here, I guess. Oh wait, before I forget. There we go. Alright. Okay, in order for, I want this area to be a bit brighter, so I think what we will do is let's go ahead and place some wall lighting fixtures over there. We will be choosing this. There we go, so that it'll look brighter. There we go. That's much better. Then, what I could do as well is I could place some plants over here beside the staircase, so that we'll have more greenery inside. Okay. That's a bit of an issue. Alright. There we go. We'll go ahead and do the same on this other staircase over here. There we go. Awesome. All right. That is perfect. Okay. That is looking good. Although this wall looks a bit empty though. I wonder what we can do over here. Oh. Ooh, okay. I have a brilliant idea. Yet again. I have a brilliant idea yet again. For that wall over there. Where is that? Well, we can have this sculpture of some sort, but it will crowd. No. Okay, we'll not go with that. Instead, where is it? Here we go. I can go ahead and have like 3 of those over there. Create wall of bubble. Awesome. That looks good. Hello there, Jolt1990. How are you doing? There we go. I mean, that looks great. And then, where is that hanging? Oh, it's over here. Green one. There we go. That looks good. Or is it a bit too high? Doing okay. That's good to hear. Thank you for stopping by. Thank you for stopping by my stream. I really appreciate it. Okay, if I do it like so. That looks okay. I guess I'm gonna go with that. There we go. And then, as for the walls over here, oh, you're welcome. Thank you. Thank you again. Anyway, I am working on this airport terminal that will function as a restaurant right now. And as you can see, I'm almost complete with furnishing the first floor. The second floor though, which will serve as the restaurant, is not yet furnished, although I will get to that later on in the stream. But for now though, I will be finishing this. Oh, I think I could go ahead and if I do put some over here, let's see how that will look like. Because I sort of want to have more greenery in this area. If I lower that, I mean, it'll look okay, but I can't stay the entire stream, I'm afraid. That's alright. I mean, I'm glad that you actually the fact that you stopped by is more than enough for me. So, thank you. And no worries if you can't stay for the whole stream, so don't worry about it. I mean, okay, I think I might have to ditch these plants since it sort of lessens the luxurious feel of this boarding gate area. I mean, which airports of nowadays has in a boarding gate area such as this? I mean, I hardly see any airports, I guess, since most of the airports nowadays are more modern and all. So yeah. Anyway, okay, where was I? I was about to think of something for this wall over here. Oh, okay. I think I have something. This is huge. Movie posters. Movie posters might work. They can serve as advertisements. Oh, right! Exactly. Good idea. Okay, no. Where are those? Or I think I could have these paintings, I guess. This one and this one. Ah, I just went over them. Okay, wait, let me go ahead and look for those. Oh, you meant these? Ah, these movie posters from the movie stuff pack. Okay, I get it. Alright. Okay. Okay, here we go. Oops. Let me go ahead and turn off move objects. Okay. Moonlight Massacre. Ha ha. And then Diamond Talker Sims. Alright. Then over here on this side, we can have Simder. Quite a nice title. It's quite catchy. Simder. That's quite a catchy title. Let's have Simder and this Super Kids. There we go. Alright, that's looking good. Yeah, that does work pretty well. Thank you very much for that suggestion. That was awesome. Okay, then I think what we can do is we can add these lights. No, I meant the lights, not the wallpaper. Okay, there we go. Let's add these lights up here. Oh, in the middle maybe. Somewhere in the middle, like so. To add brightness to that area. You're welcome. Just think of real life airports. Okay, I will. I most definitely will then. Alright. There we go. I mean, it is more, it is brighter there now than it used to be. So that's good. And then, oh, I want to have some exit rugs like over here. Just so they have a thank you for coming exit rug like some sort. There we go. And then, as for, oh, this is where I can place a good chandelier. Alright. Now that I think of it. Although, oh, I can place it like somewhere over here, perhaps. I wanna place this spiral chandelier over here. Or will that hit the head of a sim? I guess it will. It's too bad these chandeliers doesn't really work. Or rather, they're too big. So I want to have a smaller version of these since these look fancy. But I guess I will have to settle with these, I guess. If not that, these. Or I can have, for consistency, I guess I can have these lights. Like there and there. Welcome to the next search, Joel1990. Thank you very much for that follow. I really appreciate it. Alright. Okay, so I mean, we're almost done with these. I mean, these restrooms I can do later since they're quite easy to do. As for these air though, oh yes, okay, now I have that idea. Since you gave me that idea of having advertisements, Nixter sounds better than my catchphrase. Oh really? Minus welcome to the Joltastic team. Well, that's not half bad. I mean, at least you came up with something compared to others that doesn't even have a catchphrase after all. So, I mean, it's not half bad. I couldn't come up with something else. I mean, if you could just imagine how I came up with mine, I hardly had, well, I had a hard time thinking in some sort, but I sort of thought of something. I wanted something that would click. So like, Nyx. So I came up with my nickname. Well, actually, my actual nickname is Nyx. So that's why I went with the same user with that username over here at Twitch. So Nyx, okay, what could click? So Nyx. Then I sort of remembered that former that you that form that social network from before Friendster. So I was like, I think I could do Nyxster. So I was like, that doesn't sound so bad. I mean, it clicks. So then when it clicked, and then I thought of it, and I'm like, I'll go ahead and use that. So yeah, that's how I came up with mine. So we'll have those advertisement over there. Aw, thank you for the host. That's awesome. You're the second person who officially hosted me for the entirety of me streaming here on Twitch. So yeah, thank you for that. Anyway, okay, let's go ahead and I mean Joltastic. It's cute. I mean Jolt. If you mean Joltastic, fantastic. I mean that's good. It's not half bad. I mean, it's not really that bad, come to think of it. At least you have a catchphrase. So, yeah. Anyway, I want to have a plant over here underneath these posters. So, I wonder which one is good. Oh, okay. I think I'm gonna settle with these. I'll just scale it up. Like so. And you're being original with making an airport. Well, you can say that, but if it wasn't for an idea of one of my avid viewers here in my channel, if it wasn't for her suggesting to me to build an airport, I wouldn't have done this. Granted, the lot you made it on might be a bit small, but hey, next time you could build one, you can do it on a 50 by 50 lot, eh? Yeah, you actually can. There is a 64 by 64 lot actually, and I think that's on Windenburg. Yeah, I think it's on Windenburg, and I could definitely build another one on that. And if I actually my intentions for this build is that, since these two lots are sort of adjacent to each other, I sort of want to build a. Yes, I'm making one my Trident yacht on that lot at the moment. Wow, okay, a yacht. No, that is also original. Took me 10 hours already. This build, I have spent how many hours so far? Counting my off-stream and on-stream building time, my previous stream, I started this stream and then I did built it for like an hour and a half. Then last night's stream was 2 hours, and then an off I sort of built I sort of added things to these off-streams for like an hour. So that's like a total of 4.5 hours for now. Still need to do 12 rooms on the outside. Oh, that would take quite a lot of time. Good luck with that. So yeah, so far I have spent 4.5 hours with this. Add up to, well, make that 5.5 hours now. Why not save the lot and place it on a 64x64 and expand the airport? I could actually do that. I could actually do that, but I sort of want to finish the build first before I do that. And then what I want to do actually is I want on this slot over here, I want to have a hangar of some sort, a hangar that will serve as a nightclub. So it's like a, since this slot will actually be a restaurant, the terminal will be a restaurant. This the adjacent lot would be a hangar. And that will turn to be a bar or a nightclub of some sort. So yeah. So it will look like an airport complex over here, but actually it is a rest. This one's a restaurant and this one is a nightclub. So yeah, that's the idea that I was coming up. If you want, I can send you a link to some pics of the yacht, by the way. Sure thing. You can go ahead and whisper me. You can go ahead and whisper me of the pictures of the yacht, or you can go ahead and whisper me your origin idea. Oh, it's not yet done, right? Okay, but you can also go ahead and whisper me your origin ID so that I could follow you over at the gallery. Yeah, sure. Go ahead. Go ahead, do so. I mean, I would love that. I would definitely love that. Anyway, just so you could have an idea of how it looks outside, I mean, there we go. And there you go, that's how the terminal looks like on the outside. I also did this control tower over here, which I definitely love. I mean, it's a cute little control tower with all those control panels and all that. It's Joel 1990. Okay, let's just go ahead and take note of that. Where is my notebook? Oh, here. Copy paste that A0 instead of an O. Alright. Let me just go ahead and copy paste that. Control C and then. Where are my sticky notes? There we go. Then let me just adjust the size of my sticky notes right. So, right. There we go. Awesome. And yeah, I did enjoy. Yeah, thank you. Thank you for that link. I got it actually. I will check it out later. So yeah, this is the control tower. I mean, I like how it looks. It looks like an actual control tower. Only, I just really wish that this could be accessible. Because sadly, we don't have spiral staircases here in The Sims 4. Of which I could wish they could also bring back. Because remember, if you were playing The Sims for quite a while, I mean, as far as I could remember, Sims 3 had elevators and spiral staircases. So those are some of the things that I definitely want back. And as well as the ability to have to customize every single thing. Like with different patterns and all that. I mean granted that it is one of the reasons why the game lags a lot most of the time and over at The Sims 3, apart from the open world and that pattern that every time you choose an object that it loads the patterns every single time. I've been playing The Sims since Sims 1. They took a lot of stuff out that they should put back in. Yes, exactly. I have been. I could say the same actually. I mean, I have been playing The Sims as well since The Sims 1, and I've been. You can say that I have been playing The Sims for 13 years. Yes, that's definitely 13 years because I've been playing since 2003 or 2004, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, most definitely around that time, and then from then on, I have been playing every single game from The Sims. And yes, there are some things from The Sims 3 that I would definitely want back in The Sims 4. Like, just take what I've said for example. Those technically unlimited possibilities of customizing everything with patterns and all that. As well as the elevators and the elevators and the spiral staircases. So, yeah. Anyway, we're almost done with that. I think we're done here. We're almost done here, I guess. And I finally want diagonal staircases. Yes! Also, that's another thing. I mean, why couldn't they do that? They've already had four four series of games for already. And why couldn't they do diagonal staircases yet? Exactly. Wow. Okay. I wasn't really thinking of that because the straight staircases are sufficing for me for the meantime. But yes, that is one thing that I would also want to love. Diagonal staircases. Doors and windows shouldn't be locked to the grid as well. Yes. Also that. Oh god. There are lots of things that we would want to have in The Sims, but they aren't giving it to us yet. So, bummer. Yeah. Anyway. I think I could have another plant over there, I guess. Wait, where's that radish plant? No. no. Could we change the color of the pot for this? Here we go. Like I said, fourth game, no reason for it to be like that. Exactly! Technically, by now, they should have some stuff that we did, they should have been able to do some stuff that doesn't that the previous games doesn't have already. Turn on and move obviously. Yeah, I will later. I will later. Alright, that looks better. Okay, there we go. And then over here. I could do the same, I guess. I'll have this plant go over there. There we go. Now that looks that now that's a decent check-in area. Alright, so let's go ahead and decorate this second floor. I wanted to have the same wallpaper as in the boarding gates area. And then I would also want it to have the same carpet pattern so that it looks grandiose and fancy and all that. And then, as for decor, well, we could have advertisements like right over here. Although I do want a sign though. I mean, I want to place a sign of the restaurant. Oh, okay, I think I have an idea. We can have like seating areas over here, since this will technically be like a this is like a viewing deck for those who wants to go plane watching and all that. But I sort of hinder their view in a sense, because I placed this alternating waterfall feature over here because I sort of love the look of that over there. See, I mean, it makes it different. This is one of the things that I sort of did off stream, and I was like, I wonder what I could place in here, because I wanted to look sort of different apart from just having those windows and doors over there. I mean, it technically doesn't block the view from the view for plane watching and all that, but I mean, I just love having my water features. I love placing water features in all my builds. Like, none of my builds doesn't have any water feature on it. So yeah. You can also go ahead and check me out on the gallery if you want to. I mean, it's the same handle name as my Twitch username. So this is Nix20. So you can go ahead and do that. Anyway, what we could do over here is, I think we'll do the same. I can do the same seating over here. Three seats over here, and then three seats over here. Then we can have a table over there in the middle. Then we'll have a plant on these sides. Then we'll have the signs over here. Yes, that would work perfectly. Okay, that came by quite fast. There we go. And then we'll have the same plants. Ah, I didn't want to take a screenshot. But anyway, I'll just look for that screenshot and delete it later. No, not that one. I wanted this tall ones. Okay, this. There we go. We'll have these there. And there. And then one over here. One over there. There. And here. Alright. Okay. Let me just give this yacht a quick look. Oh, wow. Okay, now I'm impressed. I mean, this is really good. Wow. Alright. Wow, okay, now I'm curious. How did you manage to do that helipad over there? If you're still here. How did you manage to do that helipad over there? That's quite good, actually. Because I sort of want to do the same thing here on this airport, where I wanted to have a helipad on the roof. A lot of patience. I think I get what you mean with that. I think I understand what you mean. Raising and lowering objects. Just as I thought. Because I could only think of one thing, of a couple of things in order to get that round, perfect round helipad. That basically is 30-ish counters making a circle. Oh, wow. Okay. That is a lot of patience. Wow. And I love how you did the roofs. This is gorgeous. Like, seriously. I mean, this is the most ship looking. Most the closest thing to a ship that I found that I have seen so far, and it would be lovely for you to have that. Round counter, so no angles, right? I mean, that would be awesome for you to have that. I mean to have it on the gallery is. I bet it will get a lot of downloads. Man, the Titanic look. Titanic look as good enough. Still though, I mean this is very looking very good actually. I mean, considering that that's a Titanic. Okay, RMS Titanic. Ooh, okay, so this is good as well. Still though, I mean that this is I granted this is good, but still that one the two that th this other that other one that you have posted is way better. And this is a pirate ship with pirate ship restaurant. Wow, okay, now I'm impressed. Wow, I mean I'm sure this builds required lots of patience. Because I mean this definitely takes lots of time just from the looks of it. I am definitely going to have a look at your gallery. Yeah, I will do that later and I will be downloading these. Anyway, let's go ahead and do some more building, shall we? Should I go with the fireplace? Okay, because that fits right well over there. It's either I will go. The new one is more modern and sleek. The Titanic is an old ocean liner. They weren't as smooth lined, of course. Right. I wonder if whether I should go for the fireplace, or should I just place a table with some decor over there? I mean, since I have fireplaces here, I think I wouldn't really repeat that over there, I guess. And then I will just place some advertisements over here. And then, as over here, as for this part around here, I will have the sign for the restaurant, I guess. Let me go ahead and look for that. I like that you build the walls up. I do the same. Wall decoration finishes interior. Exactly. I've been pretty used to decorating with my walls up because I most definitely want to have a feel of how it will look like inside. Like, because when I do, because it doesn't make sense if I say, for example, you have it like there, like walls cut away. I mean, it doesn't make sense. It doesn't feel complete like when you build with the walls up. So yeah. Anyway, where was I? I was going for. Where are the restaurant signs? Yep, sculptures. Unfulfilled wall sign. Is it in wall decor? Oh, right. Not a lot of peeps think that way. Yeah, I mean, it's not that it's a rarity, but not a lot of not not there's not there isn't a majority of people that sort of think in the same way as we do. Okay, where is that sign? Java. Okay. I mean, I can go with this sign. But, nah. Nah.
go with this side. And then those signs like so. And then what we could do is it's either that or I wonder which ones I could go for. I've already used this sign. Okay, I'm gonna go for this, and then tried promoting elementary. Ah, thank you for that. Don't know if it'll do. No worries. I mean, just the thought and the actual fact that you did so. I mean, that's very much appreciated. I really appreciate it. So thank you. All right. Can this go there as well? No. Okay. I mean, that works. I'll just go ahead and check my Twitter for that then. Three new notifications. Oh well, you're nice as you know how to make a decent one, so I gotta have to. No worries! Alright, well, that's alright. Anyway, let me go ahead and finish up this hallway over here. Since the sign looks good, I mean, I'm definitely gonna settle with that sign. And then, time for me to turn on the move objects cheat. Move objects on. There we go, so that I could place some fancy little lighting fixtures beside this door. There we go. Alright, and then I can go ahead and I wonder. I'll always use Alt when I put my stuff on my walls. I want full control. Nice. Hello there, Hysterical. How are you doing? And thank you! I'm guessing you were sent here by Joel. So yeah, thank you for dropping by. I mean, there we go. Just to have a general idea of how the airport looks like, I wanted to zoom out and show you how it looks like from the outside. There we go. Then, because this airport and this build actually started when one of my viewers, who actually is just 9 years old, suggested to me to build this airport. And then I asked her, are there really planes that you could scale up? Then, because I wasn't really aware of the idea before, so until then, when she showed me this airplane, which apparently comes from the toys category on the kids area or section rather of the furnishings, I was like, if this will be the planes that we will use, I would definitely have something, a terminal more in the classic side, like those classic looking airports from the past, or those airports back in the day. So that this is how I came up with it. So yeah, because I remember these airports looks something or close to something like this before. And yeah, maybe some air conditioners on the roof and some solar panels. Yeah, I could do that. And hello there, Dragon. How's the airport going? It's going great. It's actually going great. I've actually almost finished furnishing the ground floor. So we're done with that. All I need to do is furnish these toilets over here, which I can do a little bit later. But right now what I'm focused on is finishing and furnishing the second floor, which will be the restaurant of the terminal. So yeah. Anyway, let's go ahead and... Can I give you some advice on how to make the outside better? Sure, go ahead. I mean, I would appreciate it. I mean, I'm really not yet done with the outside after all. I mean, I still want to add some stuff over here, I guess, on both sides. And also, I want to do some plants over here. Hello there, Noodle Woman. Try changing the terrain with terrain paint from the outside to make it a bit look more authentic. Nice. Okay, that I will do. I will deal with that later. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and change my title real quick because I'm guessing the edits that I want to do will consume the whole time for the stream. So I'm basically just going to finish the airport terminal. So there we go. Yep, it's an airport, or basically an airport terminal, but it won't function as one. So there we go. As you can see over there, it sort of looks like an airport. Well, it does look like an airport though, but it won't function as one. I will have it function as a restaurant, and a not too well looking airport. That nice. Alright, so yeah, I just edited my title because I doubt that I will be able to build the hangar bar on this side of the lot for this stream, since I think I'm going to finish this airport on the whole for the entirety of the stream, because considering the time that I have left, which is like an hour and a half, I think I will consume that entirety for the whole airport. So yeah, anyway, enough talk, let's go and finish this. Alright, so what can I let me go ahead and surfaces. I want to have a sort of a runner table over here, or I could use the closet actually. So activities and skills. Nope. Storage, right. Dressers. I could actually use this dresser. Be back later. Enough talk, let's do this. Yes, alright. I'll see you later, Dragon. Now which dresser to go for? It's either that or oh, this one looks way better. There we go. I'm gonna go with that. Right, and I'm gonna go ahead and do the same over here. Nice. Then, as for... Oh, it's too huge. Is it? What about the business class lounge airport as an actual fancy sitting bit for your restaurant? That is a good idea. But I mean, I sort of modeled this in those from the airports in the past where we don't necessarily need the business class lounge because the boarding gates area looks more like a business lounge already. But then again, we could actually pattern the restaurant as like a business class lounge, which is actually a good idea. Yeah. So that's why I sort of have a restaurant here. But then again, yeah, you could say that this part, the second floor part over here, could act as like the business class lounge, since lounges does have kitchens and they do have fancy seating. So yeah, I mean, that's a good idea. I mean, I could consider that. That could be, that's a good idea indeed. Anyway, let's see. What was I doing? Okay. I need another variation of a plant. There we go. I'll go for that. Then, as for what we could place above, okay, I have a perfect idea. I mean, this wouldn't make lots of sense, but if it is an airport, it will make a lot of sense. We can have television monitors over there and here to serve as like those information screens for airports. There we go. And then what we can do, this will have these advertisement posters from here. We'll have them upstairs as well. Although, wait a second. Get to work. Now, this could act as alternate advertisement posters, since technically they do look like advertisements. There we go. An advertisement for a sofa and then for a cafe. And then over here at this side, we can have this advertisement for like a music store, I guess. And then I think that's an advertisement for a museum. Wait, this one magical stone deco. There we go. That looks way better than having the okay, what I'll do. Oh, okay, so that will be too close. Yep. No. There we go. Is it the same height? There we go. Awesome. We'll go with that. The reason why I sort of enjoy the snapping to the grid or lock to the grid whenever I place objects is because I can be a bit OCD when it comes to the placement of objects and all that. So yep, that won't do. But it does look proportional after all. The one on the right is a tad bit lower. Okay. There we go. Nice. All right. Okay, then we'll do the same over here on this side. Okay, close approximately right about there. And then you could do like so. Go. Nice. It's a weird though that this one is a bit higher. Here we go. And then let's have this stick like so. And let's move it a tad bit. There we go. That looks proportional and leveled enough. Awesome. Alright. Now we can have these over there to brighten up the room at night. Because I'm guessing that will make the room so bright, like so. Awesome. And then we will have this lighting fixture over here. I will have to go. Oh, all right. Maybe I'll be back later, maybe not. That's all right. Thank you very much for stopping by, Joel1990. And I will most definitely be checking out your gallery account and gallery profile later. Thank you very much for that host and for the tweet and all that. Thank you. And I most definitely will have fun. I'll see you later. Alright. Let's see. There we go. Then I will want to have a good entry carpet. Like a welcome rag. Over here. There we go. That looks good. Yeah. Awesome. Oh my gosh, this slot already costs like 300,000 simoleons. Jeez. It's looking good on the outside. I just have to place some more lighting fixtures over here, I guess, to make it brighter. Then I want to have some lights over here on the llamas as well. Since basically that's the name of the airport, that's where the airport is named from. It's the llama. All right, let's go ahead and finish. Let's go ahead and finishing the insides then. Okay, how to go about with this? Let me just have a quick tour of the inside. I mean, I'm loving how it looks like from the inside. It's like really. Nice. That is really looking good. All right. I'm really loving how this boarding gate area really turned out. It looks fancy enough to be a hotel lobby. Ah, God, okay. And this is the security area. And I really am loving these doors, because as you can see, you cannot see through the security area from those doors. But whenever you're inside the security area, you can see through that. So yeah, it sort of gives out that privacy feel in a sense, since this is like a secluded area and an airport in some sense. So yeah, I'm really loving that. And then same goes for the immigration area over here on the arrivals area. Yeah, I'm really loving how that looks. It looks awesome. It looks awesome. Alright, okay, enough of that. Let's go ahead and decorate this place. Alright, let's see. Forgive me if I will be a bit silent for the meantime, since I'm definitely going to concentrate on decorating this. Let's see, what can we place over there? We can have plants, I guess, on this side. And then what I can do is, okay, let's go ahead and change this to a restaurant so we could unlock the restaurant items. Such as this host station. Either that or wait. Let me go ahead and put some wallpaper first so that I could have an idea on how to build or how to furnish or how to furnish this. This brown flooring like so. There we go. Nice. And then we can go ahead and add a rug. Where's the fun cute round? I guess we could have this like over there. Here, that looks good. And then this will be like our waiting areas over here. So we'll have a love seat, a lamp over here, then a three-seater couch over there. Comfort. So let's go ahead and find a fancy love seat. Oh no, this will be perfect. Since this is like the ultimate love seat. Go and then let's go ahead and use the same. There we go, that looks fancy enough. Then lighting, we'll have a standing lamp on that corner. Then we'll have the menu stands, I guess, right about where are the menu stands? Oh, they're in decor. Right. I completely forgot. Okay. Here, there they are. We can have a rug over here just so we could define the area. Oh, that's a huge rug. Okay, I wouldn't really want that. I just want an average sized rug. No, that is too small. Thank you. Then let's go ahead and add a coffee table in the middle. Surfaces, coffee tables. This is a TV stand. And yet it's considered as a coffee table. Okay. That's interesting. Yes, flower vase in there. Now that is starting to look like an executive lounge.